out. The old hat, the old orange hat with the GoPro mount.
I was wondering where that had gone. My other one broke too. Yeah. Sweet. Now I have to hold this in my mouth.
Hey, if you sent me this hat, please drop me a line. I can't remember who sent it to me and I've lost your contact details. They're awesome hats. I really want to sell them on my website. So, Jamie, I think the guy's name was. I'm not too sure. But if that's you who owned these hats and sent them to me, this one's broken because I stood on it, but the other one's still going strong. Drop me a line.
This is Sergio.
Hi.
From Spain. I suspect Sergio is a little bit happy. I'm not too sure. Sam's happy as well.
Hi.
Yes, we are going to the diving today. You look like Borat, bro. Has anyone ever told you look like Borat?
Like?
Borat.
Borat.
You know Borat?
No.
No? Borat. Can you say it's nice?
Nice.
Yeah, say it's nice. It's nice.
It's nice.
Hey!
He's a natural.
That's awesome. He's a natural. Sergio might be coming back to do some wolfing for us. You might see some more of Sergio. Anyway, we're going to drive south now, south of Fox Glacier, down to Haast, and get in the water.
Can you say, now we are driving?
Now we are driving.
No, like in a real flamboyant way. Go.
Now we are driving.
No, like now we are driving.
Okay. Now we are driving.
No, now, yeah, say it again.
Now we are driving.
Oh, bloody, he's not doing it right.
Now we are driving. There we are. You guys get it.
What a roll, mate.
They usually have these delicious ones that they make here, but they don't have any today. So what are you getting, sausage roll?
It's nice.
Hey, bro.
No.
Oh, hi. Look at that.
It's so stuck.
What the hell? That's the classic foot entrapment right there. While we're filling up our water bottles out of this delicious fresh creek here.
It's nice.
It is nice. Oh, happy day. Fox Glacier, and here we say goodbye to Sergio. See you later, mate.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. To Haast. So, Sergio, how do you like my hairstyle, mate?
Nice.
What do you think of the short shorts that us Kiwis wear?
It's nice.
Hey, Serge, do you like my gumboots?
It's nice.
Told me your lover was leaving. Yeah, I can recognize a good friend, but no one can tell you it ain't a big thing. It's a big thing.
Catch you later.
Alright, have a good one.
See you later.
Told me your lover was leaving.
I'll try not to.
This is cruel. We were just talking about bow hunting. That's Sam's goat noise. Do it again. That's pretty much what they sound. Sam's like, you gotta put some of this on there too. No way we can put that on there. It's full on. Oh, humans, eh? Aren't we a cruel species?
Yeah.
just run into Jimmy and Jack from Wanaka, and Jack was the only one who caught a fish on their massive flash boat today.
Where are you staying?
The boys had a bit of trouble getting some crays and pal, but what'd you catch a carway, Jack? Shot. Sweet. All right, lamb chops, camp, fire, cup of tea, bed. We'll go for another mission tomorrow, then boost home, and we're going to go bow hunting tomorrow night. Really looking forward to smacking a deer with a bow or scaring some away. Whatever happens, I don't know. We'll see. What is that beeping? Oh, my bloody forward drive selector is not clicking out of forward drive again. It's been doing this lately. This truck's awesome. I love it, but it does not like the wet. Do not drive it through rivers or puddles of any sort. Otherwise, the bloody electronics player. The forward drive selector. Twice now, 85,000K, second time it's been playing up. Fair call. It's always gone into forward drive. It just hasn't come out yet. As long as it goes in, that's the main thing. Because if it doesn't go in and you need it to go in and you're on the beach, yeah, basically screwed. Come on, stop beeping. Try to do that. There we go. Oh, now it's just in forward drive. Two-wheel drive, too high. It'll figure itself out. We just ran into Clint. Clint was Jimmy's boss, actually, from Wanaka in the big white boat, and pretty much coerced us into going around to his batch for a beer, which is awesome. We were just going to go camping. But he said, come around and he'll put the billy on and we'll have a nice cup of tea. Bloody started beeping again. Half a K down the road. Tried stopping and reversing, that didn't help. Oh, that's Jack. This is Max. This is Jack's little brother. And this is Clint. Clint's invited us for dinner tonight. Pretty awesome. Got a marvellous selection here. We got some carway. Here's the crayfish that Jimmy caught. That's the carway's head that Jack caught. I think the boy's going to smoke that up tomorrow, eh?
I think he wants to boil that up and eat the ice crushy.
Oh, do you?
Yeah.
Oh, sweet, sweet.
It's like the fish.
It's a Derrickasy. This is the Moki that Sam smoked, and then we got sausages and lamb chops in there, and a bit of power. So we're almost into it. Boys are just cleaning the boat, then they'll be up and we'll get stuck in. Ah, oh, funny as shit. Good morning, Sam. That ocean is as flat as a pancake. I'd like to thank Clint for inviting us to stay at his rented accommodation here, which is bloody fantastic. Clint's a builder. He's here building a house down the road. We're going to bowl on and see him before we go home, so genuine Kiwi hospitality right there. Jimmy had watched some of my videos, but I don't think Clint had, and Clint just said, yeah, bowl around, come have a couple of beers and a cup of tea and have dinner and everything, and then he invited us to stay the night, so thanks very much. Good to see some good classic Kiwi hospitality alive and well in New Zealand. Now we've got to get in our wet wetsuits, and oh, you got gumboots on the boat. I might take some of those. Look at this mess in the bottom of the boat there. So glad DNA are building me a bigger boat. I'm stoked so I can take a few more people fishing and have a bit more room. We're gonna go get some powers today, a couple more crays, and then we're out of here. Home, James. Might catch one terakee for you fellas, because I know how you like seeing me catch terakee. Oh. Hard as nails, that lad. Into it.
Right now. It's not your fault. It's just how I feel. Not at all. Ooh. Our love. Why's it gotta be so hard? Our love.
There's crayfish everywhere. It's unbelievable. Look how deep it is.
With a broken heart, my love, my love. You're lost and I'm alone. You know how I feel. You know what I want.
The cray pot. Rumour has it that the cray pot has the best fish and chips in the country, and we are about to find out.
Hi girls.
Hi.
I've actually already ordered.
So this is it. What's your verdict, mate?
Perfect.
It's pretty good, eh? Yeah. Certainly the best fish and chips I've had today. Actually, these are the best fish and chips I've ever had. Anyone else out there would like to have a crack at the title that these guys now hold for the best fish and chips in the country? It's a long way to drive. You have to drive to the West Coast and then all the way to the bottom of the West Coast. Not quite to the bottom, not quite to the Cascade, but pretty damn close to the end of the sealed road anyway, to get the best fish and chips in the country. And what a view, check it out. Someone's peeking at me around the corner there. Just making sure that I'm saying nice things about their fish and chips, I think. You girls eavesdropping, you know? I done seen a head poke around that corner there as I was talking and then saw me watching and quickly not back again.
Mm-hmm. Wasn't really working well.
Well, I never. It's a fire that isn't actually hot. Puts out no heat whatsoever. It just looks like it's warm, but it's not. Look at that. So that was a cray pot. Awesome fish and chips. Definitely recommend coming in here and checking the fish and chips out. And now we are heading home to Ross. To Ross. For some bow hunting. That's right, Samuel Harrison has made a fantastical new longbow that shoots at some ridiculous speed. He's not actually sure yet, but he still hasn't shot a deer with it. So tonight, possibly tonight, if not tonight, definitely tomorrow morning, we're going to go bow hunting for deers.
You're quiet, perfect. And they're just moving around, they're just hanging out, yep, eating the grass, drizzle, yep. They don't have a clue what's going on. You just walk up to them and bang, dead.
Dead as. So we're currently in the Abbey Rocks Lake Moriraki area. This area has been 1080 twice in the last 3 years, three times in the last 7 years, maybe. It's been 1080 twice in the last 3 years, and we just drove by two dead rats on the road within the space of 100 meters. I'm looking for an area to turn around and go back and show you people these two dead rats. Sam saw them, didn't you?
Yeah, yep. There was a bird.
There was a bird as well, but the rats didn't die from 1080 because the last 1080 drop was about a month, 6 weeks ago. It was ages ago, 2 months ago. And the rats died by running across the road and cars hitting them. The point I'm trying to make, folks, is that 1080 does not kill the bloody rats. There you go, Wakapohai River. So, Doc, if you would like to investigate, which they bloody won't, because it's like trying to get blood out of a stone, trying to tell Doc that 1080 doesn't kill rats, there's a couple of rats on the road back there that your 1080 didn't bloody kill. It's managed to kill all the deer and most of the birds as well. Hmm. Hmm.
Why the hell it be so hard?